Come on in, it's vlog day, and I'm Kimberly. This is Pretty Over 50, where we talk everything makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman. As you can see, this video is a little bit different. This is my first vlog, and I want to welcome you into my new home. Those of you that have been following me for a while know that I've been living up in Northern California, right on the cliffs overlooking the Pacific Ocean for more than a year now. And I had a glorious time there. But about 4 weeks ago, I moved back to my home stopping grounds of the Lake Tahoe area. You might be asking, why did you move if you were living on the coast in Northern California? And that's such a good question. But at the heart of it, I am a mountain girl, and my happiest times are when I'm hiking and kayaking on Lake Tahoe. So I was hankering to get back to my roots and just made the jump about 4 weeks ago. Here's where you guys come in. I've actually moved into a almost brand new 3-bedroom place, and it's absolutely empty, as you can hear by the echo, I'm sure. Truly, I moved in with nothing. I left everything with my daughter up in Northern California, including my bed and all my dishes and all my spices, everything. I moved in with just my cat and some clothes and a few little knickknack personal items. The exciting thing is that I made the decision that I wanted to furnish this place from scratch, from top to bottom. Truly, I don't even have really towels. The only towels I'm using are kind of some old ragtag ones I had left over from the beach. When I moved in, there was nothing in here. I have a few things now, but I slept on my camping cot for about 3 weeks, and it was fine. I have happy memories from my camping cot, but I'm truly glad to be now in a real bed. And I'll be showing you that in just a minute. I thought you guys might be interested in watching me furnish this completely new home. Truly, I'm starting from scratch. It's like this wonderful canvas that I'm gonna be able to create exactly what I want. In order for you to have a little bit of reference of what I'm starting with, here's some video footage of when I first chose this place when nothing is in here, including the cat. So let's take a look at that. That really sold me on this place. First of all, the kitchen is huge, which I love because I love to cook. I love the faux hardwood flooring. I think it's actually linoleum, but it looks like a nice dove gray hardwood, and I'm glad that it's not wood because I know what taking care of wood is like. I've done it before, so I'm pleased to have a little bit more user-friendly option for that. Plus, I love the dove gray coloring of the walls, the details on the doors. There was just a lot of things that really made me fall in love with it. Plus, there's a huge patio outside, so Dex, the resident cat, and I can go sit out there in the evenings. Let's go ahead and jump into the few things that I've added to the house so far. I've got some great finds that I'm excited to share with you. One of the first things I did when I moved into town is I started hitting the consignment stores for furniture because, hey, this is me, and you guys know that I don't like to spend money that I don't need to spend. And luckily I found some beautiful things. And one of them is this beautiful sofa I picked up. I feel so lucky to have found it. There are more than a few things I love about this sofa, but I'll just call out a couple of them. First of all, it's the perfect size. My living room in this area, it's a great room, kind of kitchen, living room, dining room. It's not huge, it's plenty for me, but it really couldn't accommodate an 11-foot sofa or something larger, so this is a perfect size for me. The color is gorgeous and it goes really well with the flooring and the walls, and I'm gonna really dress it up with some beautiful throw pillows and add a splash of color and a little bit of warmth to it. In addition, it is so beautifully made. It's from a company called Smith Brothers in Colorado. The couple that originally owned it moved out here from Colorado and it didn't fit in their new house. So it was almost a brand new sofa and I was able to pick it up for just a fraction of what I would have paid retail. So loving this new couch. Here's the sofa table that I got to go with the couch in. Oh, it's so glorious. It has a metal base and it's kind of a brushed silver finish. And the glass top kind of has a little ripple in it. So it's not that really clear glass that gets really dirty really easily and then you have to clean it all the time. This little chair I did order new and this is from Macy's. It came pretty quickly. It's really comfortable. It's nicely made. I'm not sure that it's going to stay here in the living room though. I think I'm going to go ahead and put this one in the master bedroom. For the living room, I think I want to get a cozier chair with an ottoman. So when I have guests over that there's more than one lounging area. This is one of those little bed in a bags that you can get now and it's a completely foam mattress. So you don't need a box spring, which I really, really like. This particular mattress was so comfortable when I was on the coast that I didn't even really look around. I just went ahead and bought the same one. And I'm gonna get this queen size mattress and put it in the guest room as well. This particular one, I believe it's a 14 inch and it has a pillow top. So it's really, really cozy and soft when you get into the bed. However, I like my bed even softer, so I've gone ahead and ordered a mattress topper to go on top of this one because I kind of like to feel like I'm going into a cloud to sleep at night. So really, really happy with this bed. It actually comes in a little package that looks like a loaf of bread. Well, I'm exaggerating. It's a lot bigger than that. But then you open it up and it goes woo, and you let it sit for a little bit and then you can go ahead and sleep on it. For my pillows, I've got to tell you guys about this. This is the Sleep and Glow pillow. Have you guys tried one of these? Oh my gosh, I stinking love this thing. I've been sleeping on it for, gosh, about a week now. They've been trying to send it to me for months and I kept saying no, no, no. And I finally said, okay, go ahead and send it. And oh my gosh, I'm in love. Have you tried it? Do you love it as much as I do? I'm finding out that I like to use it sort of propped up on my other pillow so my head is a little bit elevated. Anyway, completely loving that. I do have most of my bathroom things put away, but I don't have any decor yet in the bathroom. What I'm gonna do for the countertop, I don't like having all my beauty stuff out on the countertop, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get an aloe plant and a snake plant, which are both really, really good for oxygen. And I'm gonna rotate them between the back patio and the bathroom so I can have them in here and add a little greenery to the scene. And of course, there's my new face in my mirror all charged up and ready to go. I don't like having those out on the counter. What I think I'm gonna do is move them into the shooting studio where all my makeup is and they can just live there. I have the bathroom cupboard pretty much organized. I like to keep everything in buckets. Of course, I've got my AM bucket here, my PM bucket here, my cleansers here. I've been trying out this, let's see, vegan collagen anti-aging facial cleanser from Truly. And so far, I don't know, it's not really a hit for me, but I'll keep using it and let you guys know. I'm also trying out this Invisicrepe body balm from City Beauty, mostly just using it on my neck and décolleté. I just started about, oh gosh, 4 days ago, so I'll probably use it about a month and then let you guys know if it actually did anything. Another thing I'm trying from City Beauty is this Brow Boost. Have you heard about this? This is really easy. It's just a wand applicator inside, kind of like a mascara wand, and I just put that over my brows. I started that probably around the same time, about 4 or 5 days ago. Not sure what it's gonna do, but I'll keep you posted. And then another thing that I've added recently that I'm really liking, this is the Sukiyaka Suhara under eye cream. It's a urea eye cream. Mrs. Melissa M has been talking about this, gosh, probably for a year. I've been watching her a long time. And I finally pulled the trigger and bought it, and gosh, I'm really, really liking it. You can get this on Amazon for not very much. I think it was maybe $20. You need a tiny amount underneath your eyes. I think this will probably last me 6 months or more. Anyway, enjoying that. For my morning routine, I'm still testing out the May Love, and I'm using the Maysama Green Rooibos Press Serum. I'm really enjoying that as well. Over here, I have all my body lotions and my aloe vera gel and my spray for my new face. And then down here I have all my hair items. Here's my buckets with all my little headbands. You guys love those headbands so much. You know, you can get those on Amazon. They're super inexpensive. They come in a ton of colors. I'm really loving them. For the kitchen, I haven't really purchased too much yet. I'm still eating off of paper plates and out of plastic bowls, but I did buy this set of flatware from Target. This is called Threshold, and actually, I wanted to try them first before I bought the second set. You know, it comes with a setting of 4, and I want to have 8, so when I have company over, I'm really liking them. The weight is good. I like the shape of all the different utensils, so really enjoying this from Target. I'll go ahead and have it linked below if you're interested in checking it out. I'm going to spend the rest of the day just puttering around the house, doing a few things, maybe work a little bit. I'm so glad that you could join me for this initial vlog journey of decorating my new house. I'm excited to have you come along with me. If you're new here, make sure you smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you're interested in more makeup, skincare, and style, that's personal style and home style, stop by prettyover50.com. There's a lot more great information just waiting for you there. You guys know it just thrills me when you take a few minutes out of your day to spend it with me, particularly for this first vlog. I'm just tickled that you're here. I appreciate you stopping by and I appreciate you. Again, I'm Kimberly. This is Pretty Over 50, where we talk everything makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman. Make it a great day, wear your sunscreen, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.